And what appears to be yet another violation of the priority list for vaccination, actor Mark Anthony Fernandez told an entertainment website he was already inoculated in Parañaque City. Joining us on the line is Parañaque City Mayor Edwin Olivares, who is also head of the Metro Manila Council. Mayor, good afternoon and thank you so much for joining us.
Yes, good afternoon, Rain. Good afternoon sa lahat po ng mga nakikinig po sa atin.
Mayor, have you heard about the report on actor Mark Anthony Fernandez, as well as several other people saying that they are not part of the priority list, but they have received the vaccine in Parañaque City?
Yes, narinig ko nga, Rain, yan, at nagkaroon po kami ng investigation regarding this issue. At gusto kong malaman na mo, Rain, and mga nakikinig sa atin, na ang City of Parañaque have been implementing the vaccination program since 2 weeks ago. Almost of our 3,800 frontliners, medical frontliners, halos tapos na po kami. More than 90% to 95% na po yung aming pong na-inoculate na frontliners. So sumusunod na po kami ngayon yung ating pong priority category. Yan po yung ating mga senior citizen at ongoing na rin po yung ating mga senior citizen dito sa ating vaccination. Kinausap ko po yung ating City Health Office ng ating pong City Health Officer, Dr. Olga Bertuso, regarding the issue of Mark Fernandez. According to her, yung pong tumingin sa kanyang doktor, si Mark Fernandez pala ay meron pong comorbidities. Meron siyang comorbid. May comorbid siya. At alam naman po natin, Ray, na nagkaroon po ng depression si Mark. So, ibig sabihin yan, he is qualified for the next priority after the frontliner.
But Mayor, if we're supposed to follow the priority list, even if, for example, the funds had been used, that's coming from Parañaque City, that's been used for the supply of vaccines you already have. Is that the case here? And does that mean that we're still lacking vaccines all over the country? Aren't we supposed to be using what vaccines you still have for the frontliners in the rest of the country first?
Yes. Yung pong frontliners po natin, I have told you, Rain, it's almost done. Natapos po namin sa Parañaque. Mabilis po yung aming inoculation. Mabilis yung aming vaccination program. We do it on all parts of the city of Parañaque, including the private and public. So yung pong aming vaccination, kasi alam mo po natin, nagkaroon po ng new guidelines on the AstraZeneca. Yung unang guidelines ng DOH, AstraZeneca, yung dapat mo i-reserve yung second jab. Pero ngayon, pinagamit na nila yung second jab. Yung second jab natin, yung binigay sa Parañaque. So ibig sabihin, after the frontliner, isusunod natin yung priority group, yung senior citizen at yung mga residents na may comorbid. So yun po ang ginagawa po ng ating Parañaque. So we did not any violated the guidelines of DOH. Yung pong ating second jab na dapat po reservation ng AstraZeneca, sinabi po nila gamitin na natin para mas marami tayong ma-inoculate na residente.
So 3,800 frontliners already inoculated. What about the non-frontliners? How many have been inoculated so far, Mayor?
Ongoing po kami, Wayne, sa senior citizen, pati sa mga person with comorbids. Ongoing po kami yan. Wala pa akong data ngayon, pero sa frontliners, biligay po sa akin ng data ng aming City Health Office, we're almost done, 95% yung aming pong mga health frontliners.
So you're saying that as long as these are senior citizens, as long as they have comorbidities, that they are legally getting the vaccine in Parañaque City?
Yes, yes ma'am, because that is the prioritization given to us by the DOH.
What about the rest of the cities? Is there any request from other cities to get whatever vaccine stock you still have so that they can inoculate their frontliners?
Actually, the DOH is the one allocating for the vaccine for each LGU. Mm. Kung ano pong binaba po sa amin, yun pong ginagamit po namin. Pero hindi naman maganda, Rain, na magsosoli pa kami ng aming vaccine. So we have to inoculate the priorities group being implemented and guidelines by the DOH.
So what should people do if, for example, they are not part of the priority list but they are being offered a vaccine in Parañaque City?
So right now we have ongoing registration online and depend on the priority group. When there will be a lot of inventory of vaccine, then we will go now on the community base.
Do Do you think that there are certain groups or people or personalities right now who may have received the vaccine who are not part of the priority list? Is there a penalty that should be given to them?
They have. Mm-hmm. As far as Iñaki is concerned, itong kay Mark, bina-verify ko po kung bakit po binigyan ng vaccination dahil meron pong comorbid yung tao. Mm-hmm.
So kung kunwari, Mayor, nakatanggap sila sa Parañaque City ng vaccine, kahit hindi sila part of the top three priority list na sinasabi nating healthcare worker, senior at may comorbidities, ano po ang penalty sa kanila?
Ang may penalty po dyan, yung mismo nagpapa-inject. Mm-hmm. Hindi po yung mismong tao. Yung po ang bibigyan po natin ng show cause order, magpaliwanag sila, but hindi po sinunod yung prioritization given by the guidelines of the DOH.
And currently, Mayor, ilang areas po sa Parañaque City ang legally nag-vaccinate ng mga priority groups nyo?
So meron po kaming vaccination center with our two hospitals, yung Hospital ng Parañaque 1, Hospital ng Parañaque 2. Nagkaroon rin po tayong inoculation doon po sa mga private hospital na walong hospital sa Parañaque. At meron po kami vaccination center dito po sa City Gym ng City Hall ng Parañaque. Meron po tayong isa dito sa Mary Health of Christians na ginamit po yung ating parish po doon, ginamit. At magkakaroon pa tayong isang vaccination center na pinagamit yung Ayala Mall by Manila Bay. Mm.
And at the rate that you're going, how many are you vaccinating in a day? And ang estimate ninyo kung kailan kayo matatapos ng vaccination sa Parañaque City, ang target nyo po ba 100% of residents right now?
Yes. We're targeting the 70% to get the herd immunity. Doon sa aming simulation, we can do vaccination about 7,000 a day. Mm-hmm. So in 30 days, makaka 210,000 po kami. In 2 to 3 months, basta kumpletong inventory, we will finish the 70% target of the city population.
Mm-hmm. And what is that? What is 70% of your population, sir?
The population of Parañaque is 725,000. 70% of that is about half million.
Mm-hmm. And in which case, tapos na po kayo, that means tapos na kayo in 2 months, is that correct?
Yes. Depending upon the supply. Mm-hmm. Pag may supply po tayo, we will finish that by 2.5 months.
And next month, di magsisimula na kayo ng second jab. Tama po ba?
Yes. Yung second jab po natin na nagbigay tayo ng first jab sa mga frontliners.
And currently, how many vaccines did the DOH send to Parañaque City, Mayor?
Particularly for the 8,000 doses for the almost 4,000 frontliners. So bilanggit ko kalina, Wayne, yung pong ating second jab for the AstraZeneca, yun ang ginagamit natin for the second priority group.
All right. Parañaque City Mayor Edwin Olivares, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate you clarifying the issue with us. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.